Ronnie Millsap, Blind as a Bat.
What a difference you've made in my life. What a difference you've made in my life. You're my sunshine day and night. Oh, what a difference you've made in my life.
Ronnie Millsap right there, baby. Love that, man. Love Ronnie Millsap. I'm gonna put his albums on repeat. Just play them over and over. Huh? There's a stranger in my house. How'd he know? He smell him? Anyway. Talent right there, baby. Talent. Man had all kind of talent. Play a piano, sing. With a disability like that. It's amazing. Me, myself, me personally, on a talent scale, 0 to 10, figure I'm down there in the negative somewhere. No talent. Huh? I learn to live with it. Learn to adapt, overcome. That's what my whole life's about. I was thinking about that the other day. Look here, show you something. You see this? See that right there? Dr. Seuss? But think about it now. When that man died, he was worth upwards $70 million. Dr. Seuss was. You know? Think about that. See this book right here? Hop on Pop. Let me read you a few excerpts of Hop on Pop. Look here. Up, pup. Pup is up. Poppy is raising Cain today. Cup, pup. Pup in cup. Pup, cup. Cup on pup. Mouse, house. Mouse on house. House, mouse. House on mouse. 70 million. 70 million. All tall. We're all tall. All small. We're all small. All ball. We all, you know what? I can't take more of that shit. But I'm just saying, you gotta find your niche, baby. You gotta find your niche. Find what you're good at. Huh? Dr. Seuss was good at bullshitting people into believe he could write a book. That's what he was good at. He excelled at that. But anyway, I guess ain't no use me hating on Dr. Seuss. He did do that whole Grinch thing. That's pretty good. I ain't gonna lie. I like that Grinch. That's good stuff right there. One of my favorite. Anyway, I'll tell you what. I got some questions that people have sent me. And honestly, truly, they're amazing questions. They're amazing. They're really good. But I'm going to answer them. We're going to do this right quick. Get on off here. Because, you know, I got things to do today. I'm sure you do too. So let's check this out right quick. Check this out. Yeah. So number one, this first question right here. She said, what would your ideal life look like? Now, you know. Ideal life, you know, that means a lot of different things for a lot of different people. I mean, I don't know, money, cars, fame, fortune, whatever. But for me, my ideal life, I guess would just, I guess I'm living it. Why not? I mean, shit, I'm fairly happy. Get up every morning, feel pretty good. I do have a few aches and pains. I mean, I'm almost 50. Every time I stand up, I go, for some reason, I guess, I don't know. But I do, I mean, you know, hell, I guess this is my ideal life. Why not? Why not? What I got, might well roll with it. I don't know. There's a lot of things I'd like to change about myself, but I just don't know if I can right now or not. So I'm going to roll with it. Roll with what I got. Try to be as happy as possible. Matter of fact, I am happy. Huh? I ain't laid up in some hospital with COVID. I'm going to tell you right now, a lot of people sick right now. God, it might scare you. Anyway, number two, what is your idea? Now, I like this one. I like this one. What is your idea of a perfect day? My idea of a perfect day? Well, yet again, you know, I guess, you know what? I mean, I really don't have an idea what a perfect day would be like. I don't know. I mean, you know, get up, feel good, do some shit, go to bed. Hell, I don't know. That's a great question, though. It made me think. What? I mean, I don't know. I don't know that. That's a good question, though. Think about that. What would be your idea? And listen to this right here. I mean, that shit right there, I mean, you know. Listen to this right here. How do you think? This is another good one that I was like, God dang. It says, how do you think that you will die? Well, I thought about that too. I don't know. STD? I don't know. I don't give a shit. Number four, listen to this. What scares you most about your future? Well, I'm going to tell you right now, that's a good question too. You know what scares me about my future? Nothing. Well, I don't think about that shit. I mean, what you going to die? We're going to die? I mean, that's the future. That's what the future holds. You're going to die. But you know what? That graveyard over there, slam full of dead people. They've been dying for thousands of years. Most of them better than you, better than me. So, at least been scared of that. I mean, you know. Now, this one right here was really interesting to me. Made me think. But I, you know, honestly, I knew the answer right off the bat. As soon as I seen this question, I knew the answer right off the bat. Said, who was your favorite teacher? And why? Well, I'll be honest with you. My favorite teacher was Mary Hammer at Ellenborough, 7th and 8th grade. She was the, I guess you'd call her the language arts teacher. Okay. And she was a strict disciplinarian. She, you know, the age difference couldn't have been much wider than it was with Miss Hamrick and us. But, you know, she was so good at her job. And, you know, she was just such a good teacher that she left a big impression on me. And I think teachers, that's one thing teachers do. They leave an impression, you know, on their students that last a lifetime. So you got a big job, teacher. You got an important job, teachers. Seriously. And I'm going to tell you right now, Miss Hammer probably rolling over in her grave at the way some of you guys spell some of your sentence structure. Okay? You don't know a damn subject from a predicate. All right? I'm sure she'd like to come down from heaven sometimes and stick that, you know, number five shoe in some of y'all's ass because you don't know the distance between there, there, and there. You ain't got a clue. Or through and through. You know, you don't know the difference between through and through. Oh, my God. Anyway. And the last one, I can get on and off here. The last one is, what is the best compliment you've ever received? Now, that one right there, you know, I thought about that and thought about it. Hell, I don't know. I mean, I don't remember compliments. I remember people saying negative things about me. Hey, Connor, you ain't shit. You don't know how to talk to people, Neil. But compliments, I remember none of them, really. I mean, compliments, you forget. But bad things people say about you, hey, you remember them. I don't really care. I mean, it don't bother me. But for some reason, we remember the bad things. I guess that's just human nature. Compliments, hell, we forget them. Anyway, that's all the time I got for today. I guess I'll see y'all in a few days. I got some good stuff coming up. Stay tuned. Good stuff.